by a six gun. By a six gun they died.
You like cowboy town, huh? This is a real cowboy town. Hey? Tombstone. Yeah, look at all the horses and the cowboys. Isn't it so much fun? Cool, eh? Lots of fun in cowboy town.
Fun.
Can you see the horses? Yes. What? Okay, let's see what else we can see here.
We've had 16 gunfights here, 26 deaths, and as true to the 1880s as possible, so that when you step back, it really is like stepping back into time. Poison ceiling, the chandeliers, the bar, all here in 1881. In 1889, the silver mines closed down due to flooding, and money and people in town dried up almost overnight. The barricade was forced to close her doors.
Now, going to Tombstone has always been something that I've wanted to do. It's been on my travel bucket list. Something I really wanted to see though was the Big Nose Kate Saloon, okay? It's a very famous saloon in Tombstone and there's a lot of history around it, and it's really nice to go inside, have a drink, or go have a meal there. But something pretty interesting about it is that there used to be a janitor who worked there, and back in those days, the janitors were called the Swampers. And he lived down below in the basement, and this janitor had this genius idea of starting to tunnel underneath his room. And he tunneled for years and eventually got into the mine shaft, the silver mine shaft. There's mines that are underneath the town of Tombstone, and he started stealing silver and he started extracting this silver. Nobody has found his silver. Lots of people have said they've heard or seen his ghost in the saloon. Maybe he's come back to try and collect his silver. I don't know, but that is pretty cool. I love that place.
Thank you. How do I look, Jiffy?
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, I like the color.
Awesome. It's
very nice.
Wow.
What do you have there, Louise?
A real tumbleweed in a cowboy town.
Cool, throw it across the road, let's see. For effect. I'll put some music, some cowboy music. Louise.
Fail.
Tumble. Yeah, it's tumbling. Woo!
The second you arrive in Tombstone, you already know that you are in cowboy town and you're back in the days. And it's amazing. People are even walking in costume, in, you know, dress of that time. There is a lot to see. and do, and there's places to eat and that, and it's really, really nice. There are places and things that have fees attached to them, and maybe for a lot of families, especially bigger families like ours, that's a little bit of a negative in that you have to pay, you know, to do and experience a lot of things. There's very few free things to do. But otherwise, it's a lovely little town. It is worth the drive to get there. It is a little bit off the beaten track, but it is certainly worth going there. It is a lot to see, and I loved it. I absolutely loved it. We stayed at the Tombstone Grand Hotel, and it was really nice, but the best part of it is they had the singing cowboy. This lovely old man, and I don't remember his name, but you've heard him singing in this video. Amazing voice, and he has so many stories to tell, really entertaining, and he made the whole stay there worthwhile. Really lovely gentleman. And yeah, it's worth going to stay at that hotel just to experience his singing and his stories. So don't miss out on that. Guys, I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you ever get a chance to visit that part of the world, go see Tombstone. Spend a night there, spend two nights there. There's a lot to see and do around there. Lots of people say there are wonderful caves in the area that you've got to go see. Beautiful place. If you love cowboys or cowboy western, even if you don't like the whole cowboy movie thing, trust me, you will enjoy this place. Loved it. Subscribe. Remember, we're going west, so we've got lots more videos going west for you. And give us a thumbs up if you like the video. Comment down below, tell us, have you been to Tombstone? Did we miss out on seeing anything in the area? Because we'd love to go again. That is another place I want to go again. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye-bye.